No. Let's sing the. Let's sing the Russian of You Deserve. You Deserve.
Spices to browse in the gardens and to gather lilies. I am my lover's, and my lover is mine. He browses among the lilies. You are beautiful, my darling. Hey, just accept these words. It's about you. You are beautiful, my darling, as Tirsa. Lovely as Jerusalem, majestic as troops with banners, and God Himself loves you, the most beautiful of the women. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for this great happiness in our love, in our lives, to stay in the relationships of love. We thank you for the love that Jesus Christ, your only begotten Son, has revealed to us and proved to us. We thank you, Jesus Christ, that we can look for you, we can seek you and find you, because you are our beloved one and we belong to you. You are mine, the bride says, and I am yours. Jesus, we ask you to change our lives, to make us holy, to make us beautiful, to make us lovely as Jerusalem. as acceptable.
Thank you. gives wisdom to the wise and knowledge to the discerning. Hallelujah. Very soon, most of our countries will be voting. And we are praying that the will of God be done in the name of Jesus. We have dominion over all the nations and all over the world. And so we are praying that you have your way in the name of Jesus. Let your will be done in the name of Jesus. We cause anything of our naturalness to see that the Holy Spirit will choose his people in the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Your name.
dismissed at this time. Your pastor is waiting for you. The youth you have dismissed. Don't go yet. Don't go yet. Thank you very much. Exodus chapter 3. You'll be seated very soon. Just hold on a minute. Exodus chapter 3 from verse 13 and verse 14. And to you. Today, we are going to be talking about who I am is. And I believe knowing the great I am is knowing what it means to really worship him in spirit and in truth.
That's right.
Because you cannot worship someone you don't really know. You can praise them, but you can't really worship them. You see, in John, the next part, in John chapter 4, verse 21 to 24. Come on, guys, please help me out. John chapter 4. Jesus said to her, "Woman, believe me, the hour is coming when you will neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem worship the Father." Verse 22. Come on, guys, please. Verse 22. "You worship what you do not know. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews." Verse 23. Come on, guys, please. "Your people, God, I come against it right now, that by the power that is in the name of Jesus, that they will leave and never return in the name of Jesus. I set your people free right now. In the name of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, we pray, and the church shouts a big amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of God. Amen. So, what is worship? What is praise? Are praise fast songs? You know, we lift up Jireh, God that supplies all my need. And interestingly, when Moses asked God, "Who are you?" and God said, "I am." When God no beginning, with no end, with no parentage, with no ethnicity, sent him, he was and he is the very existence in itself. He transcended time, space, matter, and all other God. You see, at this time in Egypt, they have like about 1,500 gods. So when God is telling Moses, "I am that I am that sent you," it means "I am that is above all the other God that sent me to you." He was truly the God who existed. So today, I want to take you on a tour into the palace. But the question is this: does he really know that you're actually calling upon him? Now, me, for example, I could just walk in and go to my daddy's room. But it's my daddy. But you can't, because he doesn't know you. Now, I can't just walk in and go to your daddy's room. He doesn't really know me. So my question is this: how would he help me just because I'm shouting for help? Yes, maybe he could hear me, but I'm sure he would act differently if you were the one shouting for help. He would tell everybody, "Shh." So basically, I am trying to enter the gate of God, appreciating what he did for me. Because if I do that, I'm sure to get a new thing. I'm really sorry. I've been trying to be diplomatic, but it's hard. Yeah, it's really hard to, you know. Yeah, it's really hard to be a Christian who the only time you want to have a rapport with God is on Sunday. That is when you put on your best, because you are in the presence of your God. Oh, God said, these idiots praise me with their mouths, and their heart is so far away from me. Worship is about love. Yes. Love the Lord. Or who can climb in, who can come into his holy place? Say, those who have clean hands and a pure heart. God doesn't joke with cleanliness of hands and pureness of the heart. Those are the ones who can come in to the Holy of Holies. Your hands has to be clean and your heart has to be pure. Not according to your own definition, but according to God's definition. So, are your hands clean? Is your heart pure? Wow! This is a Christian. You want to be a real worshiper. But we have to beg you to read your Bible because it's too hard. Okay, I have news for you. You see, after this in first service, we have something called bread and butter. They study the Bible then. Yeah, but no, you won't go because you know you have a plane to catch, you have some important meeting to be. You are so important, you know? Yeah. Okay, what about Thursday Bible study? Oh, Brother Daniel, your house is so far. It's like who's making, you know, it's dirty, you know? Yeah, you understand, yeah. You know, we have these excuses we give to ourselves for not doing the things of God. Oh, smile, they like to hug you. It's just too much, you know? Okay, we have a Russian service. Oh, I don't speak Russian, man. Let your light so shine that people will see it and glorify your Father in heaven. The mount upon the hills as it shall run. You know, God has given me authority to march and trample upon the snake and scorpions and all the powers of the enemy, and nothing can harm me. Oh, I can't go. Wait a second. What about the other part? Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. And love your neighbor as yourself. You always, always do what God has told you to do. When you have these three present in your life, you are a true worshiper who worship God in spirit and in truth. That is it. Now, when you understand this three combo, it means you have a knowledge of who God is. And you understand the meaning of the great I am. It means you are a progressive Christian. A Christian that progresses from the gates to the court into the bedroom of God. Those are the ones God is looking for. God is seeking worshipers. God is looking for worshippers. God is interested in worshippers. Because God knows that you can praise him with your mouth and your heart will be far from him. So he's not really interested in that. Don't get me wrong. It's good to praise God. But if you don't praise him, you know what he said? I will raise up these stones and they will praise you. But find it in the Bible where God said, if you don't worship me, I will raise up these stones to worship me. Because stones don't understand the work of God for what they can get. It's not about that. But if you are only a praiser, as long as God still remains a Santa Claus, you praise him. But the day God doesn't really answer your prayer, you stop praising him. So brother, why didn't you sing in the church? You know, I asked God to do this for me and he didn't. I prayed to him to heal me. He didn't. I asked him to do this and do that. I asked him that, you know, God, this teacher is terrible. I want to pass this exam. And I failed the exam. What, God, are you telling me about? Oh, please. Because you are in need for what you can get. If you build a marriage relationship on that, it's going to fail. If you are in a relationship just because of what you can get, can be anything. If you build it on that, it's going to fail. Job understood that. Job said in Job chapter 1, after the devil has really taken everything away from Job, Job said, naked. Then Job arose, tore his robe, and shaved his head, and fell down to the ground and worshipped. Verse 21. Naked I came. Come on, guys. And he said, naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Because Job is not in need for what he can get. He's a worshiper. Worship. So now God is calling you today to be a worshiper. What excuse are you going to give today? You never heard it being described like this before? Well, I just did. What excuse are you going to give to God today? Oh God, today is Valentine's Day. I have to go and buy some gift for my girlfriend. Well, if your girlfriend is worthy enough, then marry her.
Mm-hmm. Marry her.
I'm very glad. I'm sure Pastor John would gladly marry you. Oh yeah, you know, married thing, that thing. Ah, man, brother, you know, it takes a lot of. And then stop doing it. Stop wasting your time. Oh, we're just living together just to share the rent. Really? Oh, you know, I'm so far away and I really miss my wife. Yeah. Go home.
Yeah.
Stop giving excuses. God is looking for worshipers. And he's calling upon you today. Are you going to be like Adam, who said, God, I heard you calling me and I hid myself? Or are you going to be like Isaiah, who said, God, here I am? What is going to be your call today? What is going to be your response? Are you still going to be contemplating about, God, I really don't want to worship you, it takes too much. But what am I going to get if I... Or just being a praiser is okay for you. As long as God keeps delivering, I'm appraising. The moment God stops delivering, the contract is off. Or you are going to be a thanksgiver. God, I'm only going to thank you as long as you keep blessing me. If I have nothing to thank you for, what do I have to thank you for? Or you are going to be a worshiper that says that even if you don't perform, even if you are not a Santa Claus, even if I don't see your face, even if I am not rich, even if I fail all my exams, even if everything leaves me, even if I'm stuck broke, even if I don't have anything, I will still worship you. Because you are the great I am. With you, all things are possible. And that is good enough for me. What is going to be your response? God is calling upon you today. He's calling. Are you going to say, here I am? Oh God, let's talk about this. Let's revisit this point tomorrow. You know, today I have a very important thing to do. You have to understand, right? Sure, he does understand. He's a gentleman. Do you have tomorrow? That's the question. Please rise up, rise with me. Clean hands and a pure heart. For you to enter, God loves you, yes, but you cannot enter his presence if your heart is not pure. So what is not making your heart pure? What is it? God is calling upon you today to leave it and come to his presence.
Oh yes, hallelujah, yes, yes.
God is here today and he wants to rescue you. If you are ready to be a true worshiper, who wants to worship God in spirit and in truth? Come forward. Come forward. God is waiting on you today. Stop looking at your neighbors. Stop looking at me. It's not about me. It's not about your neighbor. If you are ready to give God 100% of everything, like, God, here I am. Here I am. I am ready. If I'm talking to you today, come forward. God wants a worshiper. God needs a worshiper. God requires of you worship. Whatever it is that is holding you back, let it go. You are the only one who is spiritual, every other person is not. Let it go. You are the only one who knows the love. Just come as you are. God is looking for you. He's calling your name. He's calling your name. What are you going to do with this call? What are you going to do with it? Are you going to let this time pass you by? Because you have your image to worry about. Are you going to let this time pass you by? Because you have friends to worry about. You don't want to look weak in front of your friends, in front of your neighbors. But we are talking about the presence of great I am. We are talking about the presence of God. What are you going to do? He's calling upon you today. There is time. Keep coming. Keep coming. Your God is
you are mine. I will be there if you surrender everything to me. I know what you need. If you will worship me, you will get it. Come into my presence. Come into my presence. Leave everything aside. They are not important. Brothers and sisters, please join your hands together in this place. Jesus, I thank you. Lord, I bless your name. I thank you for the chains you've broken. I thank you for the deception that you've removed. God, please bring us into your Holy of Holies. Bring us to that place where you are. Let everything that we have worship you. Let every day of our life be a worshiping day. Lord, we want to be a true worshiper. Worshiping only you, no one else. We thank you, O God, for this opportunity. Be with us, I pray. Touch us, I pray. Anoint our lives, I pray. And the devil will never snatch us away from you. In the name of Jesus. Lord, I turn us, O God, into untouchable for the devil. For the worldly pressure. For the spirit of lies. For the spirit of deception. In the name of Jesus. We will be obedient to the voice of God. We will always speak to God. We will always listen to God. And we will always do what he asks us to do. In the name of God the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, we pray. And the church shouts a big amen. Hallelujah.
Before I ask you to stand up and to say which country you're from, I'll just share briefly that I just came back from Thailand, from Bangkok. And I have the privilege of standing in Thailand in the church of the IC Church. The church that says, we are here to love God and to make his love known. To Pastor Kevin Bonner. Woo! God wants to remember him. He and Sandy send their greetings to you from the Church of Bangkok. I say Bangkok to I say Moscow, Russia. And I had a chance to stand up there as a visitor. And it was great because I was heartily welcomed. And I would like for all of you who are here at ICA for the very first time, would you please stand up? Just say which country you're from. We would like to greet you. First visitors, please stand up. We would like to greet you. Okay. Right, man. Where are you from?
Africa, thank you.
You are from Africa. I see that you're from Africa.
Nigeria.
Nigeria, yes! Nigeria. And it happened to be this young lady. You are from Zagros and
Yoshi. Julia, my name is Julia.
Julia, you are from?
Bielorussia!
Bielorussia, Jewish, thank you. Praise God, we shake you. Thank you very much. Okay, and great is
Nadia.
Nadia, and you are from?
Gabon!
Kathmandu?
Yeah.
Welcome to Greetings. Thank you for being with us today. Okay. Where are you from? From Nigeria! Thank you so much for being with us on this special day. Okay, Kathmandu. You are from? Nigeria! Welcome to Nigeria today. As I see. Okay, the two men staying over there. You have my first? Yes. Gabon. If you would like to continue coming and worship with us, I say welcome to you.
Amen.
I say welcome to you.
Amen.
I say welcome to you.
Yeah.
And please be sure at the end to fill out the card that you were given and turn it in at the welcome table. Pick up your coffee cup, coffee mug as a gift from ICA and be blessed today. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Hallelujah! And this is not end yet.
It's not
the end. Praise God. Now I would like to see your holy hands. Would you raise them up? Wow, God, look at that. We love to be holy. Well, before we leave, I would like to take out your holy money. Take your holy wallet. Take out your holy wallet. Give it to the holy God. In Jesus Christ's name. Jesus, we are right here before you. God, we are in your presence. We want to see your house blessed be. We want to make your house blessed by the blessing that you give us. Thank you for the energy. Thank you for the work of God. Thank you for the opportunity to study. Thank you for every bit of money that we receive and all the other incomes through the year, through the month, through the week. God, we want to worship you with all we are. People who entered the presence of God, we want to listen and we want to do. Jesus Christ said, those who believe in me will be baptized in the name of the Lord, in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. So if you are not baptized in water yet, there is the sign-up sheet at the information desk. Please put your name, please put your address, email address, and your phone number, and listen to the announcements. We will very soon start the classes. If you don't understand why it is necessary to do, the classes will be for you if you want to be baptized in water. And the baptism will happen in the beginning of April. So God bless you all. And let us pray before we leave. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, bless this whole congregation. Thank you for a love that you shared with us abundantly today. Thank you, God, for making the love known to other people through us. When we will go from this place, God, help us to tell, to show, and to act lovely with our neighbors. For your glory, in Jesus Christ's name we pray. Bless these holy dancers today. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. And all newcomers after the church service, welcome to have coffee with Pastor Dan Abu and Pastor John at the guest center. God bless you.
Hey!
Praise the Lord!
Please don't leave this place without being served with bread and butter. They will serve it in room number 10, so you can take your coffee and go to this Bible class. It will start in 20 minutes, from 1 till 2 o'clock, room number 10, the conference room number 10. God bless your week. God fill your heart with joy and His love. Make His love known in Jesus Christ's name.
Deeper, deeper.